Hello everyone, I am Dr. Queen Aditya, Senior Consultant Gynecologist at Papilio Clinic, Kolkata. Ovarian cancer is cancer of the ovary, which is one of the prime female reproductive organs. Ovarian cancer is usually epithelial, and the commonest variety is serous cyst adenocarcinoma. Other types are germ cell tumors and sex cord stromal cell tumors. Now, how do we go about it? First of all, is how do we diagnose? Now, most of these cancers are asymptomatic, that is, they have no symptom whatsoever, and they are mostly picked up when an ultrasound or other imaging or other investigations are done for a totally unrelated condition. And accidentally we diagnose a lump or tumor in the pelvis, and then after proper investigation we come to a conclusion it is an ovarian cancer. This is one of the commonest presentations. Others are totally unrelated symptoms, as if suppose a woman comes with symptoms of indigestion, which we call dyspepsia. Indigestion, bloating, acidity, feeling very uncomfortable, and there are instances where these patients have been treated for indigestion and much later it was found out that it is actually a carcinoma of the ovary. So these are usually the presenting features. Otherwise, sometimes there is a hugely enlarging abdomen, and on examination a lump is found. This is also possible, but rather rare compared to the others. It is mostly found in women of the above 40 or above 50, but primary ovarian carcinomas in younger women is also not unheard of. Germ cell tumors and other forms are also seen in younger adolescents and in early adulthood. Then the causes. Why does it happen? Now, no one can say actually why a cancer happens, but there are certain situations in which they are found more commonly. Now, ovarian carcinomas are more frequent in women who ovulate much more. That is, in women who have had an early menarche or a late menopause, and those who have not born any children, because during the tenure of a pregnancy there is no ovulation, and also after the delivery during lactation also there is no ovulation. So there is a prolonged period of anovulation in women who bear children, and the more children you bear, the more is the period of anovulation, and these women thereby are at lesser risk for having an ovarian carcinoma. And women who have never born a children, who have ovulated more frequently, and those who have not been on oral contraceptives are at high risk of having an ovarian carcinoma. Now, there is a particular gene called BRCA1 and 2, which is more commonly associated with women who have an ovarian carcinoma. So, if this particular oncogene is found, then one should be screened regularly for an ovarian carcinoma. So, these are the predisposing factors. And as I've already mentioned, women who are on combined oral contraceptives for prolonged periods are also have a less risk of developing an ovarian carcinoma later. Now, investigations are imaging and various blood tests. And once we come to a fairly good conclusion that it is a case of ovarian carcinoma, then we treat it by surgery. It's called a staging laparotomy, and so the confirmation of the diagnosis is done at the same time by direct biopsy. In most of the cases, the uterus, both the ovaries, the tubes, the entire reproductive organs are removed, and along with it the omentum, the pelvic lymph nodes, as well as the pelvic and paraaortic lymph nodes, as well as washings from the peritoneal cavity, that is the area surrounding the uterus and tubes. The washings from that is also collected. That is the definitive treatment. And in most cases, unless it is early stage, after this surgery, chemotherapy is also required. And radiotherapy is pretty rare, but still might be used in some cases. In very young girls who have been diagnosed with ovarian cancer of very early stages, it might so happen that only a single ovary is removed and the remaining remainder is left in situ, so that she can pursue her reproductive function later in life.